Save the children.
Cheers.
There you go, Mr. Tabo and Becky. Now, Wayne may get to meet the famous people, but you can get to meet the world's most famous characters like Fred Flintstone, the Turtles, the real Bart Simpson, and lots, lots more in the flesh. How? Well, tomorrow sees the opening of the Ellsberg Steers Blockbuster Video Store, so why don't you get there and get all their autographs? Here's where. Your favorite characters at the Steers Blockbuster Video Grand Opening at Ells Park in Germiston. The time is 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. tomorrow, and when you're there, have a rave.
Now, Clinton, he's basketball mad, but there's a new fad that's hit South Africa. It's called streetball. It's a sport similar...
is full of interesting things happening in and around today, so here come all the details. If you like theatre and plays, then take note of these details. The Johannesburg Youth Theatre in Parktown are putting on a show called Mother Goose Goes to Broadway. The story is all about a family who have to save their family home, which is a shoe.
A what?
A shoe.
It's educational and a whole lot of fun. It opens to schools on Monday, which is the 12th of September, and to the general public on the 23rd of September. And remember, tickets are available from CompuTicket.
Can you imagine the smell if you have to live in a shoe? Anyway, right, if you live in the Durban area and are interested in dancing, then NAPAC, which is the Natal Performing Arts Council, have a whole lot of dance classes for both classes, and these are the times and the dates.
The Live Festival is truly alive and happening in Johannesburg. It started yesterday and runs through to the 9th of October with lots of different things happening daily. So take a close look at your screen and we'll give you a rundown of this week's events.
Looks like it's going to be just as much fun with jazz concerts happening at the zoo lake tomorrow. That's right, a jazz concert happening at the zoo tomorrow. There's absolutely no reason for anyone who lives in Johannesburg to be bored over the next few weeks. What do you say?
I couldn't agree more. If you'd like any more information, then why don't you give the Arts Alive hotline a call on 011-407-7256 or 011-407-6111 and make sure you get yourselves entertained this month. Well, that's it for this week's diary announcements. We hope you've got all the details and don't stray. Round the Bar will be back in a flash. You can watch us. Send all the details and visuals materials to KTV Kids Private Bag, North Mead 1511. Or you can call us on the Roundabout Hotline.
Oh, what an angle. So, Kimmy, can you tell me what's happening next week?
I'm not going to tell you, but it is going to be good. You'll just have to catch Roundabout next week. Until then, bye-bye. Today, Roundabout comes to you from a brand new angle.
Hey, for starters, I'm here with you.
That's right, and it's good to have you with us.
Yeah.
Now, besides Gerard sharing the hot seat with me, we also sent our blonde friend off to a museum in the hope of educating
her. That's Candy, not Kim. But you do get to see Kim cry, huh?
But let's not kid, it's tears of joy.
Great, so we'll see you with all the action right after those dudes in a half shell.
See you then. Good morning, I'm glad you could join us. Hello, Gerard.
Good morning, Kimmy. Now, seeing that you've done this before, why don't you do this morning's headlines, okay?
Okay, thank you very much. This morning, we say a big thank you to some really great folks for their contribution in saving the Cape Penguins. Candy leads us around the Museum Africa. We bring you up to date on what's happening in and around South Africa. And we chat to some young people that are going to the first ever Children's Olympics in Moscow. We also tell you where you can catch us hard at work tomorrow. So, let's get started. The Beth Susan Museum of Photography recently reopened on the top floor of Museum Africa, and we sent Candy along to see what it is all about.
Yeah, sure looks like a whole lot of fun. So if you'd like a guided tour or wish to arrange a school group to visit, then please give the museum a call.
Quincy team, we're going to take part in the first ever Children's Olympics in Moscow. Hi guys, thanks for joining us on Roundabout.
Hi Kim.
Thanks for having
us. Now tell me, you are the first and only sporting team to take part in Moscow. Isn't this going to put extreme pressure on you?
I think it's just going to be a great lot of fun. We're basically going over there just to have fun. It'll be our first international competition. So we're just going to see what's going on, how everything works overseas. So it's going to be a bit of pressure, but basically we're just going to go and have fun and see the lay of the land, basically.
Gee, what an honor to represent the country. Now, how did you guys get chosen?
Well, we mainly got chosen from our rankings from nationals out of South Africa.
And how long will you guys be away for?
For about 10 days.
So do you miss any school?
Yeah, I missed 2 days.
Cool. Yeah. Now, Hans, I believe you have a Russian coach. How has that helped in your preparation?
First of all, he comes from Russia, and he's an excellent coach. He's coached three people.
Great, you've got first-hand experience there. Well, from me and the rest of the KTV team, we wish you the best of luck and make our country proud. Please come and tell us how you did.
Great, yeah. Thanks for having
me. Thank you.
Thank
you. Kim, in the headlines you said we're going to thank some people. Will you tell me who and why?
All right, do you remember that in June there was a terrible oil slick in the Cape West Coast?
Yeah, but surely we're not going to thank them for the oil spill, are you?
No, we're definitely not. We're going to thank all the people that got involved. There were so many people. Do you remember I was in Arbor Day 2 weeks ago?
Yeah, in Cape Town. Yeah.
That's right. Well, I was so happy to see that things were getting back to normal. The beaches were clean, and the best part is that the penguins that were oiled had now got a chance to recuperate, thanks to the South African National Foundation for the Conservation of Coastal Birds.
Like who?
SANCOB. But I know what you're saying. Kim, you're speaking enough. Let's take a look at it. Is that the penguins have been transported in the car. They're all very closely packed, so it's incredibly hot. So what we have to do is we have to take a bucket of water like this one, and we have to throw water onto the penguins to cool them down. What we're going to do now is we're going to take the crates and put them onto the ship, and we're going to head out to Robben Island. So let's cool them down. There we go. Okay, let's put them on the boat. Each penguin weighs 3.5 kilograms, and there's 5 per crate. The crates are really heavy, and they bite, so you have to be really careful. Well, the penguins on board, Charlie's on board, we're all on board. There are quite a lot of people going to take a look. It's time to say goodbye to the beautiful Table Mountain, the V&A waterfront, and hello to Robben Island. With me is Henry and Kathy, who are volunteers at SANCOB. Hi, guys. You really are doing an incredible job. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let me start off by asking you, what is the purpose of SANCOB?
The conservation of coastal birds. So in a time of an oil slick, the birds are picked up by whatever means and brought ashore, and SANCOB, from then on, will clean them, wash them, and get them back to sea as quickly as possible.
All right. Who works at SANCOB?
I can't give you numbers of permanent staff,
right,
but whenever there is a problem, the volunteers come in, and they by the hundred. Kathy and I have been concerned only with the birds in the sick bay, and we've worked there continuously for about 7 weeks.
What was the most difficult part for you?
I think initially to handle the birds.
Right.
The important thing is that at the end of the day, the bird is rehabilitated and sent back to sea. That was our main concern.
What should we do if we had to find a sick bird? How can we help?
Take it to SANCOB.
Take it to SANCOB.
As soon as possible. They've got all the facilities there, and also they can call in professionals to help.
Well, I don't know. I was told we're going for like a little ocean cruise. I didn't know the waves would be this big. I'm starting to feel really sick. Let's just hope that I get there in one piece, but more importantly, that the penguins do. Hold thumbs. Well, as you can see, I survived the boat trip, and so did our lovely penguins. Now we have to carry them off the boat. The only problem is, I don't want to get bitten. How can I put my fingers in and not get bitten? I'm really scared.
There you are, young lady. Use my glove.
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
Very kind of you. Okay.
You got him?
You don't bite.
No, you might just feel a peck through the glove, and that's all.
They're really heavy. They're not biting?
Not yet.
Not yet?
You think they're dead? Oh, no.
Okay, now we're taking them off the boat. We're going to put them into the car, and we're heading towards the penguin colony. I don't know what the penguin colony is, but we'll soon find out. Don't worry, babies. You're going to be set free.
TV and the rest of South Africa, I would just like to thank all those people that got involved. Really, you did so much hard work. Thank you. And as you can see, the rewards are truly worth it.
Wow, Kimmy, that must have been really amazing. I mean, setting wild animals free back to their natural habitat.
Gerard, I can't tell you, that was definitely the highlight of my television career.
I'd just like to say thank you to everybody involved.
Absolutely.
Wow, man.
We're impressed. Well, now it's on to what's happening in and around South Africa. If you or your folks really enjoy flowers, then you must get to the Eastgate Shopping Center, where they are holding the biggest ever flower show in South Africa. It started yesterday and runs through until tomorrow. The center is open all day, and you'll be amazed at how many flowers there are. That's the Eastgate Shopping Center, open all weekend.
Those people who are leaving school at the end of this year and not sure what you want to do next year, well then why not get yourself down to the Kelly Green.
Now if you live in the Durban area, then we have got some exciting news for you. The Durban Exhibition Center is holding a wildlife expo from the 18th of September until the 25th. The expo will focus on the environment, the ecology, conservation in its broadest form, as well as a host of other green issues. In the North Plaza in front of the main entrance, there will be a typical desert oasis with sand dunes, palm trees, and wait for it, a real live camel. Yes, you heard it, camels. And if that's not enough, the largest crocodile in captivity will be the star of the Crocs World Unusual Display.
Hey, it sure sounds like a lot of fun. There's even going to be great prizes, lots of excellent food, and you can learn more about the environment. So get there if you can.
And staying in Durban, the Sappy Horse Trials are happening this weekend at the Durban Shangweni Club from 9 o'clock onwards. Today's trials start with dressage events, followed by cross country and then show jumping. Tomorrow there is lots happening for all you kids out there to take part in. There is the final round of the Miss Sappy pageant, magic and puppet shows, tractor and pony rides, kite flying and lots, lots more.
So if you're really into horses or just want something to do, then make sure you get to the Shangweni Club in Durban. Tickets are on sale at the gates and cost just 5 rand for kids and 10 rand for adults.
The Civic Centre in Johannesburg has something for everyone, and their latest project is no exception. The BMW Youth Platform is a place for young, aspiring musicians, singers, buskers, clowns, choirs, anyone in actual fact, to perform in front of a live audience.
Like some more info then
action, as well as checking out some fun, then why not come and see what happens when Bodine gets swept off her feet trying to fly a kite at the Johannesburg Kite Festival. It's all happening at Mark's Park in Emerentia tomorrow from 10 a.m. and it'll run through until about 5 p.m.
And if that's not enough, we're also going to be checking out what happens when the people at the Johannesburg Arts Festival try to do some printing. Now for those of you who have a need for speed and like fast machines,
I tell you, kids never have to be bored again. And as they say, that is it for this week's diary. Don't forget, if you have a special event happening or you know of anything happening round about your neighborhood, give us a call. And if you're calling from outside South Africa, don't worry, we'd still really like to promote it. Here is all our details. You can write us and send all the details and visual materials to Kids Private Bag, Northmead.
Well, that's it from a very, very full roundabout on this Saturday morning. I'm sure you're going to find lots to do, so until next time, from me, Kim, bye-bye.
Hey, and bye from me, too. And because I really love sitting next to you, Kim, I reckon I'm coming back next week because roundabout is such a joy.
Hasta
la vista, babies. Whoa. I'll be back.
Hi there, I'm Gerard, this is Roundabout, and here is Kim with the headlines.
Now Gerard, Roundabout's later. This is just a slight taste of what's going to be in store for you. We're going to show you what happens when sea pond Samantha went to catch butterflies.
You mean we're not going to check out how Beau coped with flying a kite?
We are, but only later. Plus, we're going to be speaking to top drum majorettes, and we're going to be speaking to kids who write for a very funky magazine just for us kids.
I get it, so you won't check us now, you'll check us later after the turtles with all the info and everything.
Spot on, see you then.
Hey.
It's time for the most informative show on kids' television.
That's right, it's Roundabout now that we bring you KTV Roundabout.
Ooh, slick. I've got an excellent idea. Let's be completely different. Start from the goodbyes and run the whole show backwards. Like, you need a plashnik,
mufnik. Gerard, you're so weird. We can't do that. First of all, this is live, so we cannot run backwards. And secondly, we are being so rude because we haven't even said good morning. So, hello, good morning.
I'm sorry, this is only my second time doing KTV Roundabout. So,
good morning, I'm Gerard Metna, and here to bring you this morning's headlines. The one, the only, our friend, Miss
Kimberly Freckleton. Good morning. Here are today's headlines. We talked to one of South Africa's top drum majorettes. Sea Pond Samantha went off to Tshwane Crater Museum to join in with a butterfly hunt. We've got news of a rave new magazine that's due to hit the newsstands. And we show you what happened when Modine went to fly a kite. But that's not all. We're also going to be bringing you up to date on what's hot and what's happening in your area.
Dudes, as you might have noticed, we've got somebody sitting here next to us. Her name's Samantha, and Samantha, welcome to KTV Roundabout this morning.
Thank you.
Hi, Sam. That is a beautiful uniform. Tell us, how long have you been a drum majorette?
Well, I've been doing it for 2.5 years.
And what is your sport entail?
Well, it's called drum majorettes, and it's a dedicated sport, and you have to take up a lot of your time, and lots of our kids in our drumming squad love it.
Now, apparently, you're going to be competing in a championship at the end of the month. Can you tell us a bit more about that?
Yes, we're going to be going to Cape Town at the end of this year. I came first for Natal, and squad came second in Natal, and we're all going to go to Cape Town at the end of the month, and we're going to compete against all the other schools.
Well, good luck. I have to ask you, aren't you scared that you're ever going to drop this mace?
Yeah, sometimes.
Have you ever dropped it?
You got lots of bruises, hey?
Yes.
Okay, Samantha, why don't you show some of your stuff?
Okay.
Guys, don't go away, because right after Samantha has shown us exactly what makes her number one in KwaZulu-Natal, we'll catch up with Sipho and our very own Samantha on their butterfly hunt. So check this out. Totally cool, but right now we're going to see Sam, the other one, doing her thing.
Hi guys, and with me here I've got Abby, who's going to be telling us more about the museum. Hi Abby.
Hi. It's a pleasure, young lady.
Okay, and from Sam and Sipon Mark, bye guys.
Cheers. Wow, looks like a really interesting place. I can't wait for the Enviro Museum to open to the public and KTV to get there for another shoot.
Now, you guys must have heard by now about the Cat Awards. Well, here are some people that are going to give the rest of us some inspiration. They are part of the editorial staff of Minimag. Hi, guys, and thanks for coming in to being with us.
I got the first question.
Okay.
Natalie, what exactly is Minimag?
Minimag is a fun kids magazine for children to read.
And what exactly do you do there?
Well, we give our advice about what kids like.
Oh, right.
This is a great magazine. James, how long have you been writing for Minimag?
Oh, we've been writing for about 4 or 5 months for Minimag.
And do you come up with your own ideas, or do they say, write a story about dancing or something?
Yeah, we are asked to write about a different theme, but we write what we feel about it.
Oh, nice.
Kimmy, you ask some more questions. I'm totally... Oh, no, wait, actually, Javian, what exactly do you do at Minimag?
The Minimag, miskien vir die volgende issue wat ek kom en sê ons vir die kinders en vrouens hulle wat wil hulle in Minimag.
So julle skryf in Engels en Afrikaans?
Ja.
Vir allemaal?
Ja.
So, hoeveel verkoop julle hierdie Minimags voor?
R4.95.
En weet jy waar julle hulle kan koop?
Jy kan hulle by subscription form kry en binne maand gaan jy het miskien by C&A kan kry.
Dis fantastisch.
Now, do you guys find this helps with your schoolwork?
Yeah.
In what way?
Well, it's got a lot of interesting things and stuff we didn't know.
Right.
So it's just that extra bit of knowledge for school.
And Karin, have you got any advice to all of our aspiring writers and myself? If we want to write, what advice can you give us?
Yes, you guys. Keep on trying. Don't give up.
Well, there you have it, straight from the horse's mouth. Thanks very much for the advice and thanks for coming in this morning, okay? You guys were great.
Thank you very much. Coming up next, Bodine shows us what happened last weekend when she joined in the fun at the Arts Alive Kite Festival.
Aeroplanes and things that fly. To see my little sister flying a two-string stunt kite, well, I'm impressed. Well done, Bo.
Well, that just goes to prove that girls can do far more than just wash and cook, hey? And now let's take a look at what's happening in and around in our diary section.
If you're an animal lover and would like to see the latest movies from Star Kinnickel called White Fang 2, well, there's no charge for the tickets. But they will be exchanged for a tin of pet food. And all pet food collected will go to the Animal Anti-Cruelty League.
Now, there is also a fun day happening tomorrow at the Y Bank Primary School in Circle Park near Kloof in Durban. This is happening tomorrow, that's Sunday the 25th, from 10 a.m. through till 5 p.m. There'll be drummies, Zulu dancers, fireworks displays, and lots of games and stalls.
If you were enthralled by the youngest stuntman in South Africa doing his tricks on his bike at the East Rand Mall, well then young Cassie O'Neill is about to maze you yet again. He'll be
The People's Theatre in Johannesburg are putting on a wonderful play for all you kids out there. It's called Once Upon a Time from Hans Christian Andersen. One by one, Andersen's stories are brought to life, like the Snow Queen, the Tinderbox, or even Thumbelina. So if you'd like to see this wonderful play, then make sure you book through CompuTicket. The play has already started and runs through until the 15th of October, just for us kids during the school break. If you'd like to make a block booking, then call the Intimate Theatre on Johannesburg 011-403-1563. That's Johannesburg 011-403-1563.
Wow, tomorrow's show looks like it's going to be a busy day. The Market Theatre is also having a children's Storyland Carnival from 10 a.m.
Now onto a project of a very important nature. The Colgate-Palmolive Foundation is offering 25,000 Rand in cash awards for South African youth groups' best community projects. Why, you may be asking? Well, because there is a desperate need for community projects which really reach out to the people of South Africa.
Who can enter? Well, any youth group anywhere in South Africa between the ages of 7 and 9.
Between January and November of this year may be entered. This includes a project you may have already done or are working on now, which can be completed and submitted in or before November the 4th, 1994. If you'd like to enter or you want more information, then give the Colgate Foundation a call on Johannesburg 011-453-1453 or write to them at PO Box 79515 Senderwood 2145.
And that's it for this week's Diary News. So make sure you join us next week when we'll be sharing more interesting news with you.
We sure will. Don't forget, if you have a special event happening or you know of anything happening in your neighborhood, please give us a call. And if you're calling from outside South Africa, we'd still really like to promote your news. Here is Candy with all our details. That a lot of you are going to your matric dances, including Gerard, so I'd just like to say have a rave, but please look after yourself. Don't misbehave.
Hey, I won't misbehave ever. So we'll see you next Saturday with all the news that kids can use on Roundabout.
Bye-bye. Let's see who they are. Well, deal with the wild thing. Let's join them.
our show today, it is Bill Nye, the science guy.
This is a liquid. This is a gas. And this, well, this is a solid.
We'll be back.
Dudes. Kim, is that you or just somebody who talks like you?
That's me, why?
No, normally you don't speak like that.
Well, as they say, a change is as good as a holiday. And that's my kid. We haven't been on holiday for a while.
Well, okay, but if we don't tell the dudes what's happening on Roundabout now, we're going to be on a permanent holiday.
That's true. Coming up this morning, we take a look at the zoo at night.
And we do some very fast driving.
Plus, we tell you all about stamps and a lot more.
So don't go away, because we'll be right back with KTV Roundabout.
Biometric dance was so pretty. It was black.
It had like...
Hey guys, we're waiting.
Oops.
Hi there, good morning. I'm Kim Freckleton.
I'm Gerard Ametler, and good morning. Here is Kim with the headlines.
Thank you. We report on some strange happenings at the Johannesburg Zoo. We stamp out any doubts you may have about stamp collecting. We take advantage of the fancy equipment that Mnet has to offer. And not forgetting the diary, where we'll be bringing you up to date on what's happening in and around your area.
Bye now, you guys.
Yesterday till the 10th of October is National Stamp Week, and here to tell us some more about it is Thelma. Thanks for coming in, Thelma.
Thank you.
Now, tell me, why is there a need for Stamp Week?
Well, the Philatelic Houses of South Africa, and that's the post office, that every 4 years they give a week to National Stamp to encourage people to collect stamps, because worldwide stamp collecting is booming. But because South Africa has been now part of the rest of the world, we will be coming in with the rest of the world now.
Now, a stamp collector is called a philatelist, right?
Yes.
Okay. I know that stamps are little things about this big. You put them on a letter when you send a place. Now, why the fascination about stamps?
Well, every stamp tells you the history about that certain country. And that's why there's also a lot of investment in stamps. If you look at the picture, you learn about the history of that country.
Right.
All right, now you have got so many stamps here. What would be the most popular kind of stamps? You've got Ghana, you've got fruits. What do people like the most?
Well, people go according to a set. For instance, if they want a theme like Birds of Africa, then they will only collect birds. Or if they want costumes and art of Africa, they only collect costumes and arts of Africa.
Gosh.
Now, what makes a stamp expensive?
It's not really expensive. You can buy toys, but what happens at the end with the toys? One should rather invest in something that will later in years will be an investment, and we must start from small to educate and train our children exactly on stamp collecting.
Thelma, how long have you been collecting stamps?
I haven't been really collecting a lot, but I've learned a lot from my dad, because as a small boy, he used to go into the rubbish bins,
really,
get the stamps out, and he's got some thousands of value of stamps that he actually collected in that way.
So you grew up with stamps?
Yes.
All right, and lastly, how would one start a collection if they were interested?
Well, these packets and also albums will be available at the Plus Chemist and Dion Chemist, and they will get fully trained exactly how to start, to the point of where a person can auction his own album, with knowing exactly the value.
Nice. Well, thank you very much for coming in.
Also, thanks for joining me.
Now, there is a saying that the sun always shines on TV. Basically, that means that on television, anything is possible, including traveling on a public road faster than a Formula One motor racing car. Confused? So am I. Let's take a look.
Whoa! I know that the drive from the airport takes at least half an hour to get here to Mnet, and that one took 3 minutes 45 seconds, so I've been doing some calculations, okay?
So don't, I repeat, do not try it. And now it's time to take a look at what's happening in and around in our diary section.
The Besley Park Primary School in Arabia.
Are people competing in the Snacker Aerobic Sport Championships and generally having a good time? Then get down to Gold Reef City today, where the Regional Aerobic Sport Championships are happening from 1 p.m. Where would you pay a visit to a farmyard right in the heart of Cape Town? Chat to seals, talk to piglets, goats, rabbits. Take your child's pet to a blessing of animals for children. See dog obedience demonstrations and miniature horse displays. Learn about different breeds of dogs. March in the midday animal parade led by a pipe band and spend time at a fun fair. At the SPCA Husky Animal Weekend at the V&A Waterfront, that's where.
The SPCA National Animal
Triple Week. M yesterday, you would have seen Gerard chatting to some of the Disney characters. Well, if you'd like to see them in the flesh and you live in Durban, then The Wheel is where you want to be. They're going to be there at 12:30 and again at 12 noon. That's The Wheel in Durban.
If you have... That's our show over for this morning, and it's always fun to be here with you guys, and especially you, Kimmy.
Oh, thank you, Gerard. But I've got some bad news. I'm not going to be here next week. I'm going to be away in Cape Town, but I will be with you in spirit.
Oh, we'll sure miss you, Kimmy. Have fun, and come back and tell us all about it, okay?
I sure will. From
us, next time, bye.
Okay, no questions. I'd like to introduce the band to you. This is Vinny Colaiuta. Stand up, man. Come on. Drummer. One of the greatest drummers in the world. Not the greatest. Dominic Miller. Guitarist. David Sanchez on keyboards. And I'm Sting. I think I am.
Sting. My name is Matthew Stewartson. I'm from KTV, which is the only channel that reaches the whole of Africa. It's a kids' channel. Is there anything you'd like to say to all the kids out there?
Yeah, I'm glad to be here, and I hope this is the first of many visits. I hope the concerts are successful. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. While you're over here, I do believe that you're going to be celebrating your birthday. Any plans for a big bash?
I think it's going to be a big bash on my birthday next Sunday.
Are you going to be invited?
Everyone will be invited.
Do you prefer big concerts, or do you like sort of sitting around and jamming, you know?
I think there's an ideal size for a venue.
in between a small club and in between a giant football stadium. I like to play theatres. I like a sort of human dimension to the place where you can see everyone, everyone can see you, without being a tiny little dot on the stage. So I prefer smaller venues, which is why I think this tour is kind of medium.
Well, I mean, I'm not a jazz musician. I'm the opposite of a jazz musician. I like to arrange music and pre-plan it. I'm lucky enough to have worked with people who are jazz musicians, people who do improvise on the spot. David, Vinny, Dominic do that. What I do is set parameters. I'm good at arranging blocks of music and finding structure and where it would go. So within that structure, the musicians create their own colors, their own journeys.
And thank you all for your patience. I'm going to talk to one for turn.
Okay, keep it down, please. Thank you.
Hey, guys, we've been there, done it. There are the questions. And if you have a look over here, you've got his autograph. Cool. All right, Matthew Stewartson for KTV saying cheers.
Well, it sure looks like the crew had a whole lot of fun, and he looks like a wonderful man. And as you guys know, it is Sting's birthday tomorrow, so that's another happy birthday for a great Mnet weekend. So, let's sing happy birthday to him.
So, from all of us here at KTV, happy birthday, Sting!
Happy birthday to you!
You. Oh yes, you guessed it, guys. The only kid show where we give away some excellent prizes from Moody Toys, like this one. It's a Chachamobile. So let's check out the winners for today.
All right, okay, let's go. Our first winner here, we've got Andrew Lowe from La Rapa.
Congratulations. Woo! And next up, we've got Graham Clifford, who's from Krasmondane.
All right. Third winner, we've got Cynthia Tomato from Alberton. Well done.
Next up, we've got Kylie Wright, who's from Springs. Well done, Kylie.
And our last, but definitely not our least winner, who's is on its way, we've got Teresa Besser from Krasfontein.
Okay.
But remember, guys, you can only become a winner if you're writing to us at this very easy address. It's KTV Kids, private bag, North Meat, 1511. Hey, Eddie, I say we get some music going. Here's Rosca Martinez with Moonlight. Neon Moonlight.
Neon Moonlight.
Power Edition, bonus play only on Kids Television.
I was just trying to disappear. I feel a smile burning in my heart. How will I explain it to my heart? The sun has set forever too long.
It seems like all